here I would like to bring in Dr. Ramesh Chaudhary, the Vice Chancellor, APG Shimla University. Sir, if you can also talk about the new trends that are emerging because of the pandemic time, as to what are the new courses that have come in? Are we talking about the digital universities? Is our reach going to go beyond the university that, to the clientele that we were catering to till now? Dr. Ramesh Chaudhary.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Jyoti. Thank you to Pranav. And warm greeting to all the learned people associated with this platform today. I'm the Vice Chancellor of the APG Shimla University, Shimla. So a warm greeting from a picturesque view. We are expecting a snowfall, and any 1 hour or 2 hour the snowfall may start. I am the almost last speaker. And time is running very fast. First, I appreciate Dr. Hari Krishna Maram, the way digitally he has greeted. And Abhay is also my good friend. We were so known to each other very long. Dr. Jyoti, you see, most of your the panelists are not associated, and only the handful people are noise. So we have listened to make this round table conference, which you have called as a more meaningful, when we are interacting and talking, and then what we have said and that has been discussed. But I congratulate to Pranav to create such a platform where we have been able to attract the people from different kind of the universities. And my university is a private state university, you know, and we are meeting the aspirations of the average students. And I know that IIT, IIM are doing very wonderful job, and they are doing since long. But I want to take this platform to understand the kind of contribution this private higher educational institutions are doing, though they are facing the discriminations in terms of the private universities. And you know, we are meeting more expectation of the students and parents. And you know, I told you that we are basically educating to the average students who want to graduate and get a job and to meet their livelihood. And then sometimes we are in the same scenario. You have to understand that we are the self-sustained universities or higher education institutions who are not getting a single rupees of the supports, and rather we are facing the Inspector Raj. So I hope with the new education policies, the wisdom will prevail, and this kind of discriminations will be somehow taken care. I'm coming to the point, which is very important, that you know that because of the pandemic, it's extraordinary circumstances, and it was extraordinary circumstances for all the stakeholder, all the segments of the society, and education is one of them. But I feel that it has proved for the private educational institution as a blessing in disguise. Dr. Hari Krishnan is there, where he is basically representing the digital universities. The best part is that, see, once we are the private educational model, where the cost is very important, we have to optimize the resources, because we are not getting, we are self-sustained universities where we have to generate revenue and then give the quality of education. So this pandemic has given a digital platform, and you see that such kind of the conferences where we are participating without any cup of the tea also and any high tea. So this is the best model for the higher education institutions, where at a very cost effective manner, we can attract the best faculty talent, and we can even take the services of the IITs and IIM. This is one thing. Second thing is that you see that the blended learning is going to be the future of the Indian higher education systems. If it were not the pandemic, it will never be the real blended learning and teaching practices were allowed, because you see that we have understood the strength of the digital educations, which were since beginning. It is nothing new. I tell you that 10 years before in an institution, I have implemented the LMS, learning management software, where everything is automated. But actually the regulating acceptance is going to come with this pandemic, where we have been allowed to conduct the viva or thesis through online medium. Otherwise, if you had done earlier, there were some kind of the questions would have arisen that what is the authenticity and other things. So this is one of the gift the pandemic has given to the higher education system in the form of digital, where we can actually implement the various kind of the technology in the educations, which will give the optimization of the resources, which will decrease the cost of the educations, and which will help us to be self-sustained, which I would like to draw the kind attention of the panelists. This is one thing is very important that we have achieved in this pandemic. Then second very good thing, Dr. Jyoti, which I would like to highlight here, the student attainment level is very high, which is unlike to the contact hour when the real campus were there. We have seen in the last semester also, we have achieved 90% attainment, which is very surprising. So this kind of flexibility and this kind of the strength is not only helpful to the universities, not only helpful to the, institutions, but to the students as well, where they are basically, they are enjoying this flexibility and their attainment level has basically increased in a many ways. So what I see that it's a win-win situation, and the Indian higher education system will learn a lot. And we have learned, actually, we have shown the kind of the maturity, and over a period of last 9 months, where we have innovated also so many things, new ways of the learning and teaching practices has been adopted, new practices has been adopted, and things are coming in better ways. And at the same time, basically this pandemic has created an opportunity of the acceptability of the blended learning system in all educational sector. That's very important that I think that's
right. Yeah, so according to you, Dr. Chaudhary, it is an opportunity. Thank you so much, sir.